In this illustration, we'll be discussing about photoelectric effect due to radiation through a lens. Here we are given that a monochromatic point source S of wavelength 6000 angstrom and power 2 watt, a cardboard A with an aperture diameter 0.1 meter fitted with a concave lens L, and a screen C fitted with a detector D of face area 0.5 centimeter square are placed in a setup as shown in figure. Here, it is asking if quantum efficiency of detector surface is 0.9 and 80% radiation passes through the lens. We are required to find the photon flux at the center of a screen and the photocurrent in the detector. We are also given with the focal length of the lens. So, first we can calculate here if a lens is placed at 60 centimeter from the source. Here we can write for lens. Here we can use u is equals to minus 60 centimeter, and its focal length is also taken as minus 60 centimeter, and we use this relation in lens formula to obtain the image. If we use it in lens formula, 1 by v minus 1 by u is 1 by f. On substituting the values, this can be given as 1 by v plus 1 by 60 is equals to minus 1 by 60, which is giving us V is equals to minus 30 centimeter. That means for the lens, if we talk about, I am here redrawing the picture to understand it with a better clarity. If this is the source, this is the point where its image is obtained. And if this is the screen, then all the light rays which are reaching on lens from the source are deviated in such a way that these light rays appear to be coming from the image. This is the image from where these light rays are coming. As these are diverging, then we can say at this position of detector, the light intensity will decrease because earlier it was going in a specific cone and now the cone becomes wide due to the diverging nature of the lens. Light is going or being spreaded in a larger area, so intensity will decrease. First, we need to calculate if source power is P, then the image power will be PI. What will be this effective power of the image as seen from the other side? As the energy which is falling on the lens remains same from the source and which appears to be coming from image, but the solid angle has been increased. As this distance is 0.6 and this distance is 0.3, then for the region very close to the lens center from which the light is passing and reaching the detector, we can equate the energies coming from source and the image at the lens center. So here we can write if effective power of image is taken as PI. Here we use, if source power is P, then we can write P divided by this 4 pi 0.6 whole square is the intensity at the center of lens due to the source. It must be equals to PI divided by 4 pi 0.3 square, which is the intensity due to image at the center of lens, if image is considered to be of power PI. Now, in this situation here, we can see the value of PI we are getting is equals to P by 4. Now, corresponding to this power of image, we can find out the intensity at the detector, which can be given as light intensity at detector, or we can say at the center of a screen, is this light intensity I can be given here as this numerical value will be given as P by 4 divided by 4 pi multiplied by the distance from detector to source is 6 meters, so this is 0.3, so this will be 5.7 whole square. If we have got the intensity at the center of the screen, then we can directly get the value of photon flux at screen center, which is given as 5, which we can write as I lambda by Hc. And in this situation, we need to consider I as intensity reaching the detector, but it will be 80% of the actual intensity because lens allows only 80% radiation to pass through it. So, here we should multiply it with the 0.8, that is 80 by 100. So, here we can write the value as, we substitute the numerical values now. I will be P by 4 multiplied by 0.8. So, this is given as 2 multiplied by the 0.2 divided by 4 pi 5.7 whole square multiplied by lambda, which is 6 into 10 to power minus 7 divided by H is 6.63 into 10 to power minus 34 multiplied by 1 by C is 3 into 10 to power 8. So, numerically, if we calculate this expression, this gives us 2.94 multiplied by 10 to power 15 photons per second per meter square, that is the photon flux reaching the center of a screen. And using this photon flux, we can find out the photocurrent in detector. Photocurrent in detector can be given as IPH is equals to quantum efficiency multiplied by photon flux, are the number of electrons ejected, multiplied by A will be the total electrons ejected from the detector. We multiply it with the charge of electron. So, we substitute the value we are given with quantum efficiency as 0.9 multiplied by 2.94 into 10 to power 15 multiplied by area of detector surface we are given as 0.5 into 10 to power minus 4 multiplied by charge of electron as 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. On simplifying the numerical values after calculation, the final result you'll get is 2.124 multiplied by 10 to power minus 8 ampere, or it is 0.02124 microampere. That is the result of this problem.